Zanth, what's the latest information you're picking up from the ground? How are investigations progressing? Filling us with all the details you're picking up.
Well, Ramesh, this is a city which is picking up its pieces. This is a country which is coming to terms with the worst terror attack which hit the country on Sunday, on the Easter Sunday, which killed more than 250 people. The count is around 290 now, including five Indians that died in the terror attack. On the ground, of course, the investigations are on. The government today is taking and asking more and more people into the investigations. Security has been tightened. When Vyond team arrived at 2 a.m. in the morning, it was completely a shutdown city. It was curfewed night until we came at 2 a.m., but we only got a taxi by 5 a.m. in the morning, because there was not a single private taxi available, and there was only one available, which was government service, and the queue was pretty long, perhaps the longest queue I have seen. But if you look at how the city is dealing with it now, it's limping back to normalcy. Since the morning, more and more people and vehicles can be seen, but of course security presence is huge. It's huge in a sense that in every nook and corner there are security personnel present, and they are frisking you, they are checking you, and security has been definitely increased at the hotels. Behind me is the hotel, Shangri-La Hotel, where one of the terror attack took place, and of course that killed many people there itself. So if you're going in one of these hotels, we are in a hotel bang in front of the Shangri-La Hotel. The security won't allow you to take your car. They will frisk you, and then you have to literally walk down with your luggage. That is the level of security. But of course, the government today will, of course, the government has already said that it's investigating. Yesterday, the Prime Minister spoke to the nation and said that he is, of course, looking into various angles, including any outside angle. Of course, he mentioned the Indian Prime Minister and other South Asian leaders. Remember, the Indian Prime Minister spoke to the Sri Lankan leadership. The President and the Prime Minister offered his condolences, and of course, any assistance Sri Lanka wants. Terror is something that India has been talking about for a pretty long time, and today this country, Sri Lanka, has faced its worst terror attack. In fact, one bomb was diffused today morning itself near the airport, where of course there is huge security presence already. But by and large, this is a country coming to terms, picking up the pieces, and of course waiting for answers on who did it, because remember, no group has claimed responsibility for this terror attack. There have been people taken into custody and into detention, but by and large no concrete announcement has been made by the government. We do expect as the day progresses more and more announcement, but by and large the worst terror attack, and Sri Lanka coming in terms of this terror attack which has taken place on Sunday, killing more than 200 people.
Indeed, and very quickly, Siddhant, reports suggesting that 24 Sri Lankan nationals have been picked up since yesterday morning in connection with those blasts. Now, although no group has claimed responsibility so far, the reports naming the so-called National Tawhid Jamaat of Sri Lanka as possibly being behind those blasts. What do we know about this particular group, and do they have any links at all with the ISIS group?
Well, ISIS obviously doesn't have presence here, but of course this group does have some connection with Islamists, and that is what the government is probing into it, because this is an attack targeted against a minority, and of course the tourism sector here in Sri Lanka targeting hotels clearly to send out certain message by these groups. No official announcement, but yes, this group the name of this group has cropped up, and of course this shows that somewhere there is some kind of angle which the government is looking, clearly not coming out or hinting directly on the involvement of certain groups in the entire terror attack. But what government is right now making sure is that there is no spread of fake news. There is absolutely clamp down on social media, whether it's WhatsApp, whether it's Facebook. In fact, Twitter is also slowing down. YouTube is not working here, and there's absolutely no way you can communicate, only by call, and that too Sethu is disconnecting repeatedly. So that this shows that somewhere the government is trying its precautionary measures, which of course as days progresses will be removed. But by and large, in the aftermath, today is the first day since the terror attack took place. The government is taking all precautionary measures and making sure. In fact, today 2 days are holiday here in Sri Lanka, and not many people are seen. People are just seen buying their essential items, which is also difficult thing to do here right now. In this city, we had to buy swims, and it was a pretty difficult task to do so because there were no shops around, and of course most of the shops were closed. In fact, at the airport where it's easy to get swims, those shops are also closed.
Right, Siddhant, thank you for now, but we'll keep coming back.